All right, welcome to week 5 of the MHP 1v1 tournament. I am Mr. JE here with Bango Bajangles, and we have the match of the week for you tonight. We are super excited. It is Homemaster versus Bangonoscopy, and I think this is going to be a really special one for a number of reasons. One, Homemaster is sitting at the top of the leaderboards right now. However, the critics would point out that he has not played anybody with a winning record. In fact, he hasn't played anybody in the top four. So I think he has a lot to prove tonight, and what is it you're going to be looking for here, Bojangles?
I'm going to look to see who comes out aggressive in this matchup. You know, Brian and David are two of the top players in the league, so I think this will come down to whoever really wants it more. So I'm going to be looking for that aggression early to see who came prepared for this game.
Yeah, for sure. I always say Bangonoscopy is super aggressive. Homemaster, though, he was really hitting a peak coming into this tournament. Unfortunately, he didn't play any of his toughest opponents at that time, so we'll see if he still has what it takes after this All-Star break. So we'll go ahead and send a message for the guys to get ready. And we'll go ahead and jump into spectator mode. All right. Here we go, we got Bangonoscopy on the blue side, Homemaster on the orange. A little stalemate of a tip-off there. Bangonoscopy gonna control the ball earlier though, puts the ball already towards the goal. He's gonna beat Homemaster to it. Ball's bouncing in front of Homemaster, trying to get on the ball. And we're seeing some of this aggression, both defensively and offensively. Oh, this is not a great clear, Bangonoscopy. Can't get around on that one, and Homemaster is breathing a sigh of relief. Yeah,
David, our Homemaster dodged a bullet there.
Oh, Bangonoscopy going for the aerial, doesn't quite get there in time. Homemaster gets around on this ball. Bangonoscopy, though, gonna be able to clear it.
Good recovery there.
Yeah, very nice, very nice. Homemaster falls back on defense, gonna see where this ball's gonna go. Snatches it. He has the boost and the advantage. Can he get the angle on the shot? He does! Homemaster scores first!
Wow. Looked like Bangonoscopy thought about saving it, but then...
Yeah, he was hoping it would go wide.
Actually hit it in.
Yeah, there's no way coming from that angle he was going to be able to clear it, and... Lucky for Homemaster, that ball was true on its course.
Very good shot by Homemaster.
Yep. Alright, again, we see Bangonoscopy with the aggression. Let's see... Homemaster is going to wait and try to counter again. Now, one of the things to note in this game is Homemaster is driving his new car from the new DLC that came out. So he says he feels more agile and nimble in this car. Let's see if that affects his game at all.
Brian, or Bangonoscopy with the change of pace dribble there.
Yep, but oh, this one's going to go a little bit wide. Homemaster trying to get back. And I apologize, the... ball cam still buggy when switching players. Alright, we have 3:20 left in the match. Both of the players fighting for control of the ball. Homemaster are going to get under this one, but Bangonoscopy gets to it first. He's going to tip it. Debates whether to go for a boost or not. He does, but that gives Homemaster time to get back and barely clear the ball. Bangonoscopy trying to show off the dribbles. Homemaster, though, knows all he has to do is just disrupt the dribble and he'll be able to recover. And he actually controls the ball, misses the boost though, and ends up stopping his dribble. Bangonoscopy helps him out though, puts the ball in the middle of the field, and Homemaster is going to score.
Wow, great shot by Homemaster.
Yeah, that bounce was unfortunate. Puts the ball in a dangerous spot, and Homemaster just has to put his car on it. Bangonoscopy almost got that save too. Wow, inches. Well, 2-0 with 2:50 left to go. Homemaster looking strong. Bangonoscopy, he is sitting at 3-1 right now. His only loss is to you, Bojangles, which was in a good three-game series. So certainly no slouch. Ooh.
he's been a bit unlucky to start.
Yeah, and definitely... you know, I can attest to the rust after the All-Star break. Not sure if you catch the VOD from my match with Banguda, but I was not expecting that one to go three games. Speaking of not expecting things, did you expect this to go in? Man, that's unfortunate. Homemaster just...
Very good shot. David using that new card to his advantage.
Yeah, he just had like a short distance.
Curling shots in from all over the field.
Mm-hmm. He just boosted a little bit, put his car on it, and the ball traveled. This is a great tip off from Homemaster 2. Bangonoscopy, good job turning around and being able to get to that ball first. But he's only got 2 minutes left, and he's down 3 goals. He hasn't scored yet.
Yeah, I think if nothing else, Bangonoscopy needs to get his groove back before the next game.
Yeah, he's showing two shots. That's a great aerial, but it's just a little bit wide. Homemaster actually helps Bangonoscopy out a little bit, gets another touch on it, but Homemaster's still able to clear and control it. Bangonoscopy, ooh, his car goes a little awry there. Otherwise, that would have been a great counter if he could follow up. He's two gonna ping-pong it back and forth in the corner. Ball to the middle of the field. Bangonoscopy gets up first. Looks like he's out of boost, though. He's gonna pick up 100 right here. This is his chance to attack, but gets the ball right on Homemaster's car. Trying to cut off the quick angled shot that Homemaster's going for, at least the dribble. And he succeeds, but he still has to worry about this ball in his corner. But a great challenge there to clear it and pop it up. Up the side. This is going to come off the corner. Can he get around on it? He can. Homemaster hits
good
the
goal.
Ball. Yeah, but kind of just squirts off the wall. That's an unfortunate clear.
Unfortunate. Homemaster was there, but just couldn't get enough force on the ball.
If his car was only a few inches to the left, that ball might have squirted back into the corner, but it's not the way the cookie crumbles.
Maybe if he was using one of the retro cars...
Maybe,
yeah.
Your car.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good point.
Prevented that goal.
Oh, here we go. Bangonoscopy with a great opportunity. Can he get the angle? He can. All of a sudden, it's 3-2. That's two quick goals. No kidding. 53 seconds left. This game is far from over. Homemaster needs to calm his nerves a little bit. Keep doing what he was doing before and... not making mistakes, waiting to counter his opponent. Oh, but this tip-off is not going to be good for him. oh, man. 3 goals on 6 shots. Bangonoscopy. Homemaster is, I guarantee you, cussing like a sailor when that ball's in.
This is what we love about 1v1.
And that's also what we hate when we're playing. Bangonoscopy says calculated. Indeed. He spotted him a 3-goal lead just to come back. In about a 20-second span. Alright, 3-3. Homemaster hasn't lost this game yet, but I may have spoken too soon. The ball bounces over Bangonoscopy. Oh, goodness. It's already game one, and my heart is racing. I don't know about you, but Jangles. Homemaster misses the clear. Bangonoscopy gonna try to get around on it, but he was way too far back. He was just expecting Homemaster to control that. He missed an opportunity there.
I agree, you know, it's hard to comment on what's happening before without something else amazing happening.
Yeah. Bangonoscopy went back for boost, and he doesn't get punished for it. Homemaster didn't move the ball out of the corner yet. Bangonoscopy got to put this ball towards the goal, but he's passed it. Homemaster's going to clear it, and barring some amazing dribbling skills that we have not seen, this is going to be overtime. Here we go. 3-3. Homemaster had a 3-0 lead. It disappeared in a matter of seconds. We're going to see controls this. Homemaster has the boost and the ball. Great ball off in the corner. Bangonoscopy. Oh, goes past it. Homemaster, can he get through it? Oh, shows nice patience there.
Savage.
Wow. Bangonoscopy, he comments, he says, nice shot. But really, what's going to be the story there in overtime is that missed clear, the big whiff by Bangonoscopy. And Homemaster, you're going to take game one.
Wow, what an exciting comeback, though.
No kidding. I mean, Bangonoscopy showing that, hey, this isn't going to be a walk in the park for you, man. So,
Homemaster escapes with the win, but I think Bangonoscopy shakes some rust off in that one.
Yeah. Look at that score, 520 to 510. Does it get any closer than that? 5 shots to 6. No saves from either player. Now, Homemaster, no more for his assists than his saves. But Bangonoscopy is definitely pretty good on defense, particularly in hoops, but also in soccer. And if you can write ready up there, Bojangles, for the players. But yeah, surprised to see no saves for Bangonoscopy. Definitely in that last game, he literally liked to save there in overtime. Alright.
I think, I predict a Bangonoscopy win in this one.
You know, I think... Man, I don't know.
I think... just be me being greedy and wanting three games.
Yeah, I think I'm with you too. I think the crowd wants three, but I don't know. Homester just made a couple of mistakes. I don't think he's going to keep making those mistakes, man. So unless Bangonoscopy really turns it up, I think Homester's going to take game two. But Bangonoscopy trying to prove me wrong and score on the board first, but he's not very crisp right there.
Gotta take care of those opportunities.
Yeah, he couldn't get the right angle, couldn't flip the ball up, and Homester, with the momentum, takes it down the field. Homester's just being a little disruptive. He's not always getting great clears, but he's stopping any momentum that Bangonoscopy has towards the goal, forcing him to reset offensively. Right there, just getting that little bump. That's really huge to be able to take control of this ball. It's going to score it into the blue corner. Homester trying to track down, pick up boost. Bangonoscopy, though, going to get on it. He didn't pick up the boost, though. Did he pick it up right there? I'm not sure if it was him or Homester. Either way, Homester going to control this ball off the left side. Pushes it back middle. Bangonoscopy recognizes it. Bounces it off the ball. Wow, lies down on the floor for Bangonoscopy, but Homester able to get in front of it, just deflect it. He's sitting in the goal, waiting to see where this ball goes. Not a great clear, but oh, it gets a little flick on over Bangonoscopy's head. He's going to put this one towards the goal, and he has the boost and the speed and the distance advantage. And he's going to score first again. Very nice shot. Good control by Homester. He is going to be able to play from ahead again. Bangonoscopy with a score of 25, Homester 95. And we got about 3.5 minutes left to go. Alright, Homester going to take this one to the corner. Now, Bojangles, do you think Bangonoscopy here is still thinking about, you know, trying aerials? Oh, you know, I say that, and then he scores. That's a great challenge right there on that ball. He put his car right on the ball, right over Homester.
We know Bangonoscopy has been practicing his aerials, but he himself said that they are not a good strategy in 1v1, so it will be interesting to see how he employs that strategy, if he does.
Yep. And he's going to win this step off here. Homester, though, the ball bounced so high, he has time to get back on it. Clear it, get the boost, try to take possession. Bangonoscopy says, nope, we're going to keep this ball here. I'm going to make you get a better clear than that. And this is a great little meat drop. Bangonoscopy tries a little aerial a little too soon, hits the ground before the ball. And Homester is going to pick that one up, bring it into the corner. Picks up boost, going to put it towards the goal, but that's easy for Bangonoscopy to clear. Homester trying to reverse, doesn't actually flip those, and the ball just kind of pops up. Oh, that's not a great clear. And now Bangonoscopy definitely has the fast break advantage. But he doesn't have the angle. Homester got to go up on the wall. Can he Spider-Man this? Ooh, he does! Wow. What a save!
David, I got to watch the replay.
Oh, man, no kidding. Spider-Man himself, the Homester. This is a clear right in front of the goal. Bangonoscopy jumps up, gets a spin. Homester still had his wheels on the ground.
Hard-fought goal. There was some tough defense by Homester.
Yeah, that clear. You know, he just doesn't even jump until the end there. You really have to be on top of that ball. Makes me think that he maybe didn't have any boosts left either, but even still, just a double jump is all you need.
It's hard to predict because in that position, the attacking player can jump at any moment.
Yeah, and even if you're off ball cam, you can't really see where your opponent is, and Bangonoscopy, he's starting to gain his momentum here. Homester out of boost, tries a front flip, but there's no way he's going to catch up. That's a 16-second goal. 3-1 now. Now Homester's the one. He gives up three straight goals again, but he didn't have the three-goal cushion this time, so he's going to have to come back now. He picks up boost, and he's just kind of sitting there backwards, kind of an awkward position. Bangonoscopy challenges, but Homester actually gets the ball out, so now he's going to control this, bring it towards the goal, but it's a little too lackadaisical. Bangonoscopy now going to come over Homester's head once again with the challenge. Homester in that awkward corner position. puts the ball across the goal. Has enough on it. Oh, this ball is going towards the goal. Homemaster using his boost and his great power sliding ability to curve around that ball and get at the right angle. Oh, if he had landed on that clear, he actually might have been able to follow this ball up. But this might be even better. Oh, but he's a little too high and wide. This, unfortunately, is going to be great for Bangonoscopy. He doesn't have boost and he flips past the ball. He misses the angle.
Can get you surprisingly far downfield.
No kidding. Oh, and Homemaster, though, able to come around and get a couple of good clears. Oh, goodness. All right, well, there's still only a minute left, and Homemaster needs to get on the board twice. It's plenty of time, especially if Bangonoscopy misses challenges like this. But Homemaster has to get the ball, too. What is going on here?
Bangonoscopy just takes control of the ball in that situation.
And those, you know, that didn't really cost him as in terms of being dangerous, but it cost him a lot of time because Homemaster missed the clear, had to come around the ball again. He is kicking himself there. That ball goes over the top crossbar.
Yeah, I was surprised when Bangonoscopy went past the ball, Homemaster wasn't able to take advantage, but sometimes you're not facing the right direction.
Ooh, this is going to be the right direction, though, and Bangonoscopy can't get back, so it is 3-2, 23 seconds left. Homemaster loves these kind of shots where he gets to... He uses his geometry skills, okay? And his pool skills that he honed throughout high school. The ball's going a different direction, he goes a different direction, and somehow he pushes it towards the goal. Homemaster getting a little tricky there on the defense on the kickoff. He waits for Bangonoscopy to kick it into him. Where's Bangonoscopy? Okay, there he is, in front of the goal. He's going to come out and challenge us. 10 seconds left. Homemaster, he probably should have waited for that ball a little bit more. This could be something. Oop, doesn't get the angle. It actually sets it up for a Bangonoscopy clear, and that's going to do it for game two. Bangonoscopy with the air dreidel. Yeah.
He must be relieved to pull out that victory.
Yep. And you got what you wanted.
Well played.
The viewers got what they wanted. We're going to a game three.
We're going to game three.
So we're 4-3 in overtime game one, 3-2 in game two. These are incredibly close matches. We just say three saves from Homemaster in that game. So seeing a little bit more defense, but he didn't score as much. You know, I one of the things that I'm seeing from Homemaster is just that he's a little more indecisive, and he's been out of position a lot of times, and I've seen him just kind of stop and not know whether he should go backwards. He's not very comfortable going backwards and flipping, so he pauses and hesitates, but then he actually doesn't try to get his car around until it's a little too late. So let's see if he can correct those mistakes here. He does a win the tip-off and the boost. See right there, he was backwards, but he went around. He knew he had to move. Bangonoscopy not going to be able to get back on this one. A great little flick from Homemaster right over Bangonoscopy. And again, 13 seconds, a quick goal from Homemaster. That's three games straight where he's been on the board first. Nice shot. Bangonoscopy is showing some good sportsmanship here in the game, keeping it light. Maybe that's good for him. Now, I didn't get a chance to talk with the players before the game, but I believe you did, Bojangles. How are they? Were they feeling? Were they loose? You know, how many drinks do they have under their belts? What was their mentality going into this?
Yeah, I think both players were ready for the matchup, mentally prepared. Bangonoscopy mentioned he got in some warm-up matches.
That's good.
Homemaster was excited to, you know, test out his new car in the 1v1 arena.
Mm-hmm. Alright, Homemaster going to bring it up on the left side here, using his boost. Bangonoscopy misses the clear, this is going to bounce towards the goal, but he's able to jump up and tip it towards the middle of the field. Homemaster 2, see, he just gets that little hit, and it doesn't do a lot in itself, but it forces Bangonoscopy to react.
That ball almost bounced in.
It did. It was just a few feet in front of the goal, but the angle, fortunately, wasn't quite right. Bangonoscopy waiting to see what Homemaster does, and he sees him with it.
He's an opportunity.
Oh, the Homemaster meets him for the challenge, and they just sandwich the ball. Great save.
Epic save there.
Alright, this ball's going to come down. Homemaster waiting for it. Gets the flick on. Doesn't go for the aerial. He knew he had time. His opponent didn't jump for it. He's going to push this one off the wall, but it's right in front of Bangonoscopy, but not much on it, so Homemaster's able to counter that with his own hit. Now he's going to come up the wall, hit this one down, doesn't get much on it though. He's going to pick up the boost, try to flick it over Bangonoscopy. Ooh, he does! Wow, impressive. Let's watch this.
Wow, yeah.
The patience, ooh, Bangonoscopy, just the front flip, definitely not high enough. I don't even think if he double jumped that would have been high enough. Bangonoscopy just waits for it to roll in front of the goal for the score. He's up 2-0, 3:06 left to go, game 3. Bangonoscopy with the first touch, but the ball is on his side of the field. Flicks it over the Pokeball in center field.
Down 2-0 in game 3, it looks like Bangonoscopy is going for the aerials.
He's pulling out the stops. He says, you know what, I won game 2, but I'm down now, and something's got to change. And it's going to be his aggression. Speaking of aggression, Hullmaster winning that challenge boosts around.
Hullmaster still riding that new car swag.
No kidding. Wow, it's a second goal in a row where he just flicks it over Bangonoscopy's head and pushes it in. Well, we saw in game 1, Bangonoscopy come down from 3-0, and this could be the start of that. Wins the tip-off. Can he get the angle? He does, and it's 3-1. I'm a prophet. History is repeating itself. It is cyclical.
Some would note there's plenty of time left.
For sure, we're not even halfway through. Yeah.
Indeed.
Number one champ. Is that a little BM there? The car topper from Bangonoscopy there? Showing Hullmaster, you may be number one right now, but I'm the number one champ. Alright, Hullmaster waits for this clear. He's going to control it out of the corner. Going to pick up the boost. Bangonoscopy, though, gets around, challenges it, times it well. Now he's going to be on his counter. Hullmaster, though, getting physical, pushes Bangonoscopy out of the way, doesn't let him
enforcing.
Get... Yeah, oh, again, another hit. We haven't seen demos, but we've seen a good number of bumps. And, like, key bumps. Hullmaster takes that boost. This is a bit of a meat drop. He needs to jump and make sure he gets in front of this. He barely gets the back of his car on it to push it backwards. You think that was calculated? I don't know if he meant to hit it the way he did. Oh, picks up the boost again. Bangonoscopy's gonna have to go into the corner, pick it up. He doesn't. He goes for the ball instead. Hullmaster not expecting that. And Bangonoscopy gonna come down. Hullmaster knows he has no boost though, so he's not scared. Again, picks up boost. Bangonoscopy going for the boost now though. Ooh, Hullmaster misses that clear. That's gonna be bad. Bangonoscopy misses the wide open shot though. No, not like this. Oh, we almost had 3-2. Hullmaster now knows he just needs to buy time. He's got 80 seconds left. 2-goal lead. Just keep putting the pressure on like this. I mean, this could be a goal. Gets the tip. Oh, puts it right towards Bangonoscopy, and he actually knocks it in.
Hullmaster determined not to have another repeat of game 1.
Oh, Bangonoscopy just had to let that one go.
Yep.
Hullmaster mishits it, misplays it off the drop, but Bangonoscopy there to help him out. Unfortunate goal. 4-1.
Tough break there.
Yeah, 65 seconds left. Bangonoscopy not going to give up though, because he could score right here, and he got the goal back. 4-2, minute left. Plenty of time, for sure. That was an 18 second goal. He's already showed several times that he can score right off the kickoff. So, well done there. Great patience, calm nerves. If you're Hullmaster, are you a little scared? Are you playing a little anxious?
You know, I think no lead is safe in this 1v1 tournament.
Yeah.
As you and I can attest to.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, even if you have the lead, you know it's not safe, so you can never be complacent in this game. Oh, but Hullmaster, wow. That is an amazing shot.
You know, a four goal lead with under a minute feels pretty safe, but under that, you know, I would still be trying to score goals to be aggressive.
But that's got to be disheartening for Bangonoscopy, because he just scored a goal and then had one scored right on him. But it was a great side flip by Hullmaster, pretty much a 90-degree angle. You have to time that perfectly and make sure that you don't go flying past the ball. That was wonderful. And Bangonoscopy is dreidling in the middle of the field. I was wondering why he wasn't on defense there. I think this
that
one's...
last play may have broken his back.
Is he lagging here, or is he just... This is some weird dreidling going on. calculated. Okay, well, this one seems to be in the books, folks. Hullmaster gonna try to run up the score, trying to get that point differential to see if anybody matters in this league. We don't even know. Now the funny thing is, Bojangles, these two guys are our opponents for next week. Week 6 is the hype week.
Wow. So this just sets up another round of hype.
Yeah, no kidding. You will be taking on Hullmaster, and I will be taking on Bangonoscopy. And it looks like both of us are going to be fighting for our undefeated records. And if we both win our matches next week, then we will be playing the Battle of Undefeateds in Week 7. So I'm looking forward to that. Your schedule gets a little easier after Week 6. Finally, you've definitely had the hardest schedule, I would say.
But I'm not undefeated.
You're not. But things will definitely change in Week 6. It could change. We'll see. So Hullmaster are going to take Game 3 in a game that was closer than it looked. The final score, 6-3. And we'll go ahead and pull the guys in here for a quick interview.
Hello?
Hello, welcome, gentlemen, well to the caster's desk. GG, well played. Hullmaster, you won game one, lost game two. What were you thinking going into game three?
That I was going to get a little bit luckier than Bangonoscopy on those hits, and luckily fortune favored my side, certainly on a few of those bounces there.
So Bangonoscopy, would you agree that it was pretty much luck that separated the two of you in game three?
No. I played like shit.
What do you think you could have done? What was it that fell short for you in the games?
I was on tilt. It was just shit. I was shit the whole game.
Even after winning game two?
I had a slight period in game one where I was coming back. Mm-hmm. Game two was okay, but I was missing shot after shot after shot. It was shit.
Yeah, you were down 3-0 in game one, came back to tie and force overtime. And in game two, you were down 1-0, and then you scored 3 goals straight again. So you were definitely capable of going on runs.
Yeah, I was off. It's off my game.
Yeah,
David had a much better game than me.
I think we definitely, yeah, we saw some, probably some rust that we're going to see in week five, naturally after the break. Just some misses that we don't normally see, but...
No, I was playing earlier today. I was not playing so badly.
I just woke up from a nap before we played. So
yeah, I don't know what it was,
power
guys.
Power naps, man.
Yeah.
When you go on a streak of badness, you're really. I was in the zone of shit.
The zone of shit.
Well said.
All right. Well, that's gonna do it for week five. Tonight's feature match brought to you by Montucky Cold Snacks, and we will see you for the last two matches of the week. GG's.